In this video, we are going to talk about
cofactors.
Before talking about cofactor, let's talk about enzymes. How do enzymes work? Enzymes work by converting the substrate into transition state and then transition state into product. What is a substrate? Substrate is the molecule on which the enzymes work. So let's say this is the substrate,
this is the transition state molecule, and this is the product.
And the enzyme acts on it. Now, how does enzymes act on the substrate? Well, enzymes are made of proteins. Proteins are made of amino acids, and amino acids have got functional groups. So these functional groups interact with the substrate. How do they interact? They interact by charge to charge interactions, or maybe acid base catalysis, or maybe transient covalent bond formation. So in this way, the enzymes interact with the substrate and forms the transition state. Transition state is a state where the state, this molecule is no longer the substrate, but it has yet not formed the product. Okay, so this way an enzyme acts on the substrate and forms the product. In between, the transition state is there. But we already know that we have got the, in our body there are only 20 standard amino acids. Since you have got only 20 standard amino acids, you can understand that we have got only limited number of functional groups. Okay, so the repertoire of chemical reactions which an enzyme can catalyze is limited. So in some cases, or in many cases, we need additional molecules to catalyze the reaction, or to help the enzyme in catalyzing the reaction. And these additional molecules are known as
cofactors.
So this, in this context, let's now talk about cofactors. Okay, so
cofactor.
Now, a cofactor can be of two types. It can be a metal. Or it can be an organic molecule. If it is an organic molecule, it is known as coenzyme. Okay, and coenzymes generally come from vitamins. Now this side, if the metal is tightly bound to the enzyme, it is known as, the enzyme will be known as metalloenzyme. And if the metal is loosely bound to the enzyme will be known as metal activated enzyme. For example, carbonic anhydrase has zinc as the metal of the metalloenzyme. An example of metal activated enzyme is hexokinase. Here, magnesium or manganese is loosely bound. So the enzyme is known as metal activated enzyme. So if tightly bound, the enzyme will be the, if the metal is tightly bound, the enzyme will be known as metalloenzyme. If the metal is loosely bound, the enzyme will be known as metal activated enzyme. Here, on this side, organic molecules can be of two types. If the organic molecule is tightly bound to the enzyme, it is known as prosthetic group. prosthesis. Okay, so if it is tightly bound, it is known as prosthetic group. For example, thymine pyrophosphate or flavin adenine dinucleotide. If the organic molecule is loosely bound, it is known as co-substrate. Co-substrate. In that case, the example will be NAD, nicotinamide adenine dinucleotide. Co-substrate, the word co-substrate is used because, like a substrate, the molecule attaches to the enzyme and then is released. So since it is loosely bound, it is known as co-substrate. So in summary, cofactors can be of two types. They can be organic molecule or they can be metals. If the metal is tightly bound to the enzyme will be known as metalloenzyme. If the metal is loosely bound to the enzyme will be known as metal activated enzyme. On the other side, if it is organic molecule, it will be known as coenzyme. Okay, if the organic molecule is tightly bound, it is known as prosthetic group. If the organic molecule is loosely bound, it will be known as co-substrate.